Good morning, everyone, or afternoon, or evening, wherever you are in the world. Welcome to this week. We have a new moon this week, and it is right smack dab on the whole lineup of planets that have been giving us all so much drama for the past month or so, or actually all since last year. So the grand conjunction is being activated this week. So we have more newness, more fresh beginnings, and more having to do things in a new way. So this is really what the key element is to the energy shifts that are going on in the world. We are being led to a new way of approaching life and a new way of dealing with our own emotions and inner state. So the most important thing to do is to be connected to your body knowing, your heart and your gut. Your brain is deceiving. It's very deceiving. It can deceive you very easily. And we have Mercury retrograde, which is all lined up to deceive us and mess with our heads. So be very careful with this retrograde of Mercury because it is also going over all these grand conjunction degrees. So there's a spin, there's a confusion, there's mind mayhem, there's just a hard time perceiving the truth and getting the thread through all of this. So just expect confusion. Just know that we're all being confused and that is on purpose. So it's very hard to know what's what in any given moment right now. So the mind is not necessarily the thing that we can trust in as having the ultimate ultra authority over everything. That's kind of the key thought here. I want to leave you guys, I want to give you guys for this video. Hold on a sec, my cable is twisted. There, okay, straighten that out. So let's look at the charts and I'll talk about it, but let's just give you a little heads up on what's going on with crypto. Right now, Tesla has announced that it's going to make it possible for people to buy Teslas with Bitcoin without having to make the exchange between Bitcoin and cash. So, Tesla also just bought a big chunk of Bitcoin. That's very bullish for Bitcoin, of course. Long term, we are completely bullish on Bitcoin long term. But in the meantime, there's all kinds of moves up and down. And this morning, it did break out to a new all-time high on this news. The rumor is always buy, in stocks, it's always buy the rumor, sell the news. Well, that was the news. I'm not saying to sell. But we are at a new all-time high. I'm not telling anybody, none of this is financial advice. You know, what's going to happen next? Are we going to go, shoot the moon? Are we going to go down and have a correction? What's happening? I just did a big, full, all members video devoted to this subject, explaining what's going on and how there are way more than just two forces battling it out inside the markets right now. We are in a giant bid for power, and there are many, many separate forces that are trying to take over all the financial markets at the moment. So it's a big drama going on in the world. There's a lot going on that you can't see. However, the markets are going to do what they're going to do. And if we are, have our heads on, clearly we can get in at good places and get out at good places and take our profits and roll them into more profits. So that's what my membership is devoted to. So, come on over and join if you want that information. But this week, let's take a look at what's going on with the markets. Of course, we had the ETH. I'm going to, one other crypto piece of news is that the ETH futures contracts launched today. So that's kind of a big deal because it's basically another way that the cabal can manipulate the prices of these cryptos. And I do expect that, of course, long term, Bitcoin's going way over $100,000 long term, way over. But there will be trade opportunities in the meantime for those who understand these specific, sort of like bus stops, places where you can get in, places where you can get off, places where you can get back in, and be making more profits. And there's a lot of other coins, as alt season is starting, a lot of coins are starting to warm up. They haven't really popped like popcorn yet, but that's coming. I mean, some of them have. Dogecoin certainly has just popped on news that it's affiliated with Tesla. It's also affiliated with a coin that I I recommended to my VIPs about 2 months ago, which is going to be a really huge coin. I'll talk about it to my pro members this week, and then I'll bring it out to the main membership here in the next couple weeks, so people can all get in on it while it's at a good price, and while they get a good opportunity with that coin. So it's going to be really important, this new coin. So there's a lot else going on in this market. I mean, Digibyte's finally outside of its resistance at 3 cents. It's finally above that. So there's a lot of movement that's happening, and there are some coins I'm very much expecting to see big things out of. So the question is really when, right? And that's really where astrology, crypto astrology, gives us an edge in understanding the timing of when certain things can and cannot happen. I don't know everything. I'm not God, but I do have a much better handle on the timing than anyone else I've found out here. So if you want to have an idea of when those windows of time can happen, and if you are ready to take responsibility for your own portfolio and your own moves, because no one else can hand it to you in this market, it's just too dramatic, then come join us in my membership, and we'd love to have you. So, okay, so let's go look at what's going on in the chart here for this week. So astrologically, this is a week of, again, a lot of, you see all that red in there? That's a big, big square, right? Big challenging aspects that are taking place. And that is all being stimulated by the new moon, and it's squaring Mars, which is moving into an exact square to that new moon, those new moon degrees here over this next week. So we have a lot happening, and Mars is squaring Mercury. So there's a lot of actually aggressive communication, actually angry outbursts, and people losing their temper. And you want to be really careful about that, because people are losing their temper based on false information. Mercury's retrograde. The information is not true, or it's a historical old issue that you might have in your own past, in your own history that hasn't been resolved, some kind of emotional thing that's a subconscious trigger that's being triggered, which is essentially what all this spin in the media is about. And there are a couple of really good sources if you're looking for real information, for the real, if you want to find your way through all this and find the knowledge of what's true, then there are sources that are valid. And those I've posted inside my members area, and I posted inside a recent video I did about the drops, the information that's here. I posted one of them. So if you want the actual documents, if you want the actual facts, if you are not emotionally triggered and capable of looking at things from a clear, rational space, that's the people who are losing their temper through this this drama are people who haven't done their own inner emotional work. So it's really important for all of us to stay as calm and possible and to deal with whatever comes up. It doesn't mean staying calm doesn't mean not dealing with the emotional triggers. It means breathing through them, working them out, clearing off the belief systems that are coming up, because nothing like the money markets to bring up everyone's freak out mode, and on nothing like all this political spin to bring out everyone's strongly held, issues and beliefs. And when there's giant rage triggered inside of someone, that is their history being triggered. It is their unresolved baggage. It could be trauma. It could be probably usually is some sort of trauma. And that is stuff that people act out on each other. And this can lead to a civil war, right? This can lead to great violence in the United States. And that is what's going to happen. And all the mind story is being spun and twisted. And so people are making rash, aggressive moves based on false information. So, and it's basically fear, right? It's all based on fear. So don't believe fear, FEAR, false evidence appearing real. Fear is a lie. The only thing that is real is love, which is why I really want to emphasize how important it is to be coming from your heart and from your gut. That's where your good decisions come from. Your gut has brain cells in it. The true decisions of your body knows what's good for you and what's not. Your heart knows what's good for you and what's not. Your heart also has a different kind of brain wisdom. So it has brain cells. They're not the same as the ones that, it's not like the same type of thinking as what's going on in your head, but it's a better place to make decisions from. So there's heart and gut going on. And meanwhile, Mercury retrograde, creating havoc, causing communication problems, disrupting people's flow, causing a short circuit to the system. So the key here is being adaptable and flowing through it and, not getting pulled into these angry fights. I mean, people are very angry about things and they're misinformed, right? And so you've got to be very careful about conversing, engaging with this kind of aggressive energy. So, and also if it comes up in you, work it out rather than, on somebody else or getting triggered into some sort of battle with someone else. That's only going to cause problems. So, however, there is a great opportunity right now. I mean, basically between now and the 11th, 12th, because Mars is making a nice aspect to Neptune on the midheaven. So this is a there may be an opportunity here to accumulate metals. There may be a good opportunity to accumulate things for your long-term benefit and long-term goals and growth. So if you're impatient, don't want to wait for things to come to you, then you can take some actions here that will have long-term potential for you in your life. So there is a good, that is the one sort of saving grace with Mars, is that we can take a lot of good action. And also, with Neptune, it's good for being at the ocean, by the sea, in the water, connected to anything that has to do with agriculture, growing metals, things like that will all be very nurturing, fulfilling, and rewarding. Maybe you just go out and you pull some weeds and you do some gardening and it makes you feel relieved and grounded again. I mean, Taurus, that's Virgo, right? The earth sign of Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, all the grounding signs. So you can do things that are of those energies to help ground yourself. Taurus is more about your creature comforts, like maybe get a massage. Capricorn, go for a hike. You know what I mean? Like get all that going and you will help to ground any electrical energies that you're feeling. So people are really getting triggered emotionally. So if you're getting into some angry battle or if some anger is showing up, then you can take those actions to ground that. Whether it's your anger or someone else's, it doesn't matter. Going out and finding those ways to ground it into the earth and release it will make a huge difference. So there's and also Venus over here is conjunct Jupiter on the 11th, also providing a nice little bump financially for someone in some way, shape, or form. So there's some pretty good stuff going on in this week. And also, this Mars Pluto trine is over. That ended. But Mars is also triggering the nodes this week. So it's really asking people to sort out the truth. I mean, the node, the North Node being in Gemini, which is all about the truth. And I, was talking to my friend who's a Gemini, double Gemini, the other day. And he's like, I think I'm being extra killed by this retrograde. And I'm like, I'm sorry, you probably are, because it's a big thing for someone who's a double Gemini, but it's also on the nodes of the world. So it's really giving all of us a notification to sort out fact from lie, truth from fiction. Have some discernment. It's your nose sniffing out the truth. That is what Gemini is about. So it's really about having to be a bit of a detective for your mind, even while the mind is being short-circuited right now, either through overwhelm or through spin of stories going in multiple different directions, or people just getting angry and acting out and saying stuff out of anger, or just opinionated that doesn't have any grounding, right? So when it's really forceful and has a lot of intensity like that, and it's not grounded, you're looking at something that's not it's not going to be helpful, right? These are all the tricks that the mind plays. When what we really want is to get into the heart knowing and the gut knowing and get into the ground, get into the body and the calm space, because you cannot make good decisions from a mentally frenetic place. It's just not possible. As Einstein said, no problem can be solved from the level of consciousness that created it. So that what does that mean? It means we have to sort of elevate our energy in order to get past a problem that's arising. So, I mean, I've had plenty of Mercury retrograde issues, creating thorny situations in my life, but I've just used it as an opportunity to research other options and opportunities and other types of solutions, because that's really what Mercury is for. That's really what the retrograde of Mercury is for. It shows us where the problems are. It highlights the issues so that now we know what they are, so we can go back and fix them. Like, if you didn't know, you had a crack underneath your feet, you know what I mean? And like, things were shaky, and then suddenly it would fall through and you wouldn't have any warning to fix it. But if there was some warning, and the universe always gives us warning to fix things and to solve things, then we can go in and we can solve it. And I was in one of these seminars where the way he put it was that when there's something we need to look at, right? When there's a solution, a soul question, something we're trying to learn, when the universe is trying to get our attention, there's feather, brick, and truck. So feather is the universe tickling you with this little tiny intuitive, like, nudging that's very little, that's saying, hey, this is, you might want to do something about this. And those will kind of like ding, ding, ding a few times. And if you would go, no, and you push it off, later on, the universe is going to hit you in the head with a brick, like, hey, pay attention. Something painful and bad and difficult will happen with that. The brick is representing something that's really, dramatic, that you are like, you really need to pay attention to this. And if you still don't do anything about it, then you're going to get hit by a truck, because this is the universe trying to, give people a nudge, give the individual a nudge in the direction of something important. So those of us who are more intuitive are more tuned into the feathers generally. But sometimes we all have blind spots, and some of those bricks will hit us, and we have to like wake up and reassess where we're going. So that's what's going on a collective level. And it is taking people into a state of greater self-responsibility. That is the winning attitude. That is the those are the people who are going to be the successes, and the leaders of the future are people who are taking charge of themselves and not looking for answers or someone else to do it for them or tell them how, or all those things. Yeah, you can hire someone or whatever to teach you something, that's fine. But ultimately, if you're it's you in your little lifeboat yourself rowing. So it's really important that every individual know how to row that boat, have their life vest on, have their supplies in that lifeboat, and know how to move forward with a plan of some sort, but still be prepared that there's going to be choppiness on that, on the waters. So that's really the overview for the week of what's going on in the world, and also crypto. There is some stuff going on in crypto. Bitcoin has made a new all-time high, and it will make new all-time highs. We are going, of course, in the long run, to go to super high levels, way over $100,000, but that's not going to happen this week. And that's a long-term move. And if you want to know the different levels, and I stopped getting too specific out here on this channel, because on YouTube, because people start blaming me for what the market does. And the bottom line is, the market will come to these levels, but the question is when. So if you're not paying attention to every little move, or if you're over attending every little move and you're expecting something to happen at a certain place exactly on a certain date, then you're going to overthink it. So sometimes I get, psychically I'll get levels, but then I try and match it up with the astrology, which gives me the windows of when it's possible. Nothing is ever guaranteed. The market is heavily manipulated, as we all know, and I'm just getting information on what the manipulators are about to do, better really than pretty much anybody I know about out there. So that's kind of the best we are ever going to be able to get, I believe. I do work really hard to try and get you the best that's possible, but there's no guarantees. There's no guarantees in any market. But long term, if you're really worried about the market, just buy it and hold it. Look for good entry points, which I do give in the in my members area. So that's it for today. There are still some good cryptos to buy. There's still some bargains. So that's I'm trying to find my I'm kind of I've got a lot of things in front of me on my desk. So let's just sign off for today, and I can't see it, so I have to move it. this. All right. We will talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.